Hello everyone, I am Nikhil Kumar, welcome back to the channel. If you are managing automation with AWX or Ansible Automation Platform, today's video is an absolute must watch. We will explore how to set up organization, projects and credential, and how these elements work together to make your automation workflows more efficient and secure. And if you missed my last video on AWX execution environment creation, make sure to check it out. I have linked in the description and up here in the corner. Execution environments are vital for running your playbooks effectively, and they complement the topic we are discussing today. Now let's jump straight into the demo and see how it's done. So this is my AWX. So let me log in on this. First, let's create an organization. Organization in AWX or AEP help you manage and segregate resources like inventories, credentials, and project for different teams or business unit. So let's create an organization. To create an organization, we need to navigate to the organization in the AWS dashboard. So here we have an option to add an organization. Let's add one organization, that is test AWX org. If you want to give some description, we can give some description, test organization, and save. For example, in a company, you have separate team for DevOps, IT, and security. By setting up organization, you can restrict access to resources and allocate them based on the team responsibilities. Next, we will create a project. A project in AWX is essentially a link to a repository where your playbooks are stored. This could be a GitHub, GitLab, or any source control repository. Let's create a project here. So I'm giving one name to the project, that is test project GitHub. And here we can specify the organization under which organization it should be associated with. So it's test AWS org, which we just created. And here we have a different source control type, manual, git, related insights, and remote archive. So I'm going with the git here. And here we need to specify the repository URL. And if our repository is private, we can specify the credential. So I'm going to create a credential first for our repository. So let's create a credential for our GitHub repository. For that, I'm just going to go into credential and click on add, and I'm giving GitHub creds, and I'm associating with the organization test AWSR. And here we have a different types of credentials. So we can specify for the source control here, and here it's look for the username, that is Nikhil811, and we can specify our password as well, or token. So we are specifying the token here, and username is nikkumar811. So save. Now we have created a GitHub credential. Now let's create a project. So for that, let me go into the project, add project, and test project, associating with the organization, and specifying the source control type git here. And here, let's first create one repository that should be a private one. New. I'm creating like test repo, and it should be private. So to add it, we need to get the URL and go into the project and specify here. Here we need to specify the branch, from which branch we need to pull the code. So I'm going with the main branch here, and here we need to specify the credential. So that is GitHub credential we just added. If it's a public, we don't need to specify the Git credential here. And there are separate options for that. Like if we want to sync the project each and every time, whenever we made some changes in the code and when we triggered the job template, it will automatically sync the project. So I'm not keeping it because it's unnecessary wasting the resources to sync the project each and every time for each of the job template. Let's save it. Right now you can see that it got synced, and we can see the job here as well. It's a source control job which is trying to connect with the Git repository we just added. Now let's add one code here, the sample code, to see how it should work in the AWS. So I'm giving a test playbook.yml. And I'm specifying the task, that is localhost. I'm giving a task name, that is debug task. I'm using a debug module and specifying the message. Playbook from GitHub. And commit these changes. So we have created one file, and so we have made some changes in our GitHub repository. To sync this changes with the AWX, we need to sync this project. So there is an option to sync this, that is a test project. Once we sync this project, we can get all the playbooks which are available on the GitHub repository. To see how it should be working, let's create one sample play job template. So I'm creating one job template that is test GitHub repo. So here we are specifying the inventory. I'm just giving the demo inventory here. We are creating one project. We have used a project that is test project. And execution environment, I'm just using the default one. And the playbook, there is only one playbook, that's why it automatically picked up. And if we are using some credential, we can specify here as well. So let me save it. And let's trigger this playbook. I'm going to cover job template and workflow in more deep dive in the future videos. So as you can see, it started the process. As we can see, we have written a playbook in our GitHub repository and it's able to execute the same playbook. And we can see that is the output which we have entered over there, that is playbook from the GitHub. So let's jump onto the credential as well. Credential in AWS stores sensitive information securely, like token, password, or SSH keys that are required for accessing external resources. Just like we have added the GitHub credential to access our repository, which is private. So it will be very useful in those scenarios where we are going to use the authentication method and it requires a password to be used. Instead of clear text password, we can specify the credential in this particular section. Now let's create a credential and use it in our playbook. And to do that, I'm going to create one credential here that is test credentials AWX and associating with the organization. Credential type is machine. And specifying the username of that particular machine and password. So it's done. And to connect with that machine, I need to create an inventory. So I'm going to cover this inventory in more detail in my upcoming videos. For now, I'm just creating a static inventory quickly. So I'm giving some inventory name that is test inventory. And specifying the organization, and I'm going to add a host in it. So it's done. Let me create a playbook very quickly. I'm going to create a playbook, check creds-pv.yml, and this particular playbook will be running on the all the nodes under that inventory which I created just now on the AWS task. And here I'm specifying the name, check host name, and giving a module name that is shell. I'm going to run one shell command that is host name, commit the changes. Let me sync the project so that we can see that playbook, that is test project. So it got synced. Let me create another job template. Creating a job template with JT, that is job template. Check host name. I'm running on inventory, that is test inventory, which we created just now. Project it's test project. An execution moment is default one, and playbook that is check creds py. I'm going to use a credential that is test creds AWS, which is created now. Let me save this and launch this playbook. As we can see, it's able to connect with that, and if we see here, it's able to get the hostname, that is Nikhil. This approach can be useful when you need credential to access other private resources within your playbook task. And that's it. We have seen how to set up organization, projects, and credentials in AWX and how to use them in playbooks. These steps are essential for securely managing your automation workflows, especially when working with private repositories or sensitive operations. In the next video, we will cover inventories, starting with a static inventory, and dive deep into job templates and workflow for more advanced automation scenarios.